Hello everyone, this is Ritesh. Welcome to my channel. Today I am going to show you the installation of Docker containers on Windows Server 2019. There are only few steps to install Docker on Windows Server 2019. So let's start with the activity. First step is to install the module, Docker module. Before that, we have to go to Start, open PowerShell. PowerShell command to install. PowerShell command to install the Docker module is install hyphen module space module name, that is Docker MSFT provider hyphen repository. So repository path is given as PS Gallery by me. That is, PS Gallery is the Microsoft site. It will download from Microsoft site and forcefully install. Once it's done, hit enter. I'm going to give all the commands in the description box after this video. Once you hit enter, it will download and install the module from the Microsoft site. Now it's asking, do you want to install? Yes, no, or you can suspend. Also, if you press question mark, it will give us the help. Now I want to install. I am hitting Y to install, that is yes. Hit enter. You can see that module has been installed. You can see installing module. Here the module is successfully installed, because if there would be any error, it would be represented here. Next step is to install the package of Docker. To install the package, the command is install hyphen package hyphen package name. Now we are installing Docker, so I have selected the name as Docker. Provider name is Docker, the module name which we have installed. I am giving the module name. Hit enter. Once you hit enter, it will take 5 to 7 minutes to install the package. Meanwhile, I will tell you about the container. Containers, it is basically used to run application. Application may be Windows platform or Linux platform. Basically, most of the containers are used in this environment are Docker. Some people use Windows, some people use Linux. There is also OS RKT, Core OS RKT container available in the market. There is a Windows Hyper-V container also available. The containers are taking place in this world. They are mostly used as it is easy to deploy. It is easy to stop and start. So containers are used nowadays. for deploying the applications. Archiving now the package. Once complete, you will get this message. Name of the package that we have installed, that is Docker. Version, what is the version? Source from where we have installed, and the summary, what it is. Once we install, it's time to install the feature. Windows feature of container. Once you run the command, hit enter. Here I have given restart needed. Restart needed, I have provided to show you that is restart required or not. If restart is not required after the installation of Windows feature, the option will give you no, but it says yes. So let's restart the system now. The command to restart is restart hyphen computer. Enter that command, hit enter. You can see Windows getting update. After rebooting, it will finalize before the desktop appears. Once server is rebooted, we will log in. Now we have installed the module, we have installed the package of the Docker. We have installed the feature, Windows feature of container. Now it's time to pull the image, Docker image. The command to pull the Docker image is Docker space pull and the image name. Hit enter. So you can see that it is pulling the image from the library, hello-world. Meanwhile, the image is getting pulled. We will summarize what steps we have done. First, we have installed the Docker engine. For installing Docker engine, there are two steps. First, we install the module of the Docker. Second, we have installed the package of the Docker. Third, we have added Windows feature of containers. Windows feature space containers. After installing the Windows feature, we have restarted the computer. Now we are pulling and downloading the image. Once the image is downloaded, we will run the Docker image. As you can see, the image is getting downloaded. Image has been downloaded. Extracting is in process. Now we have downloaded the image. It's time to run the image. The command to run the image is docker space run and the image name. Hit enter. Once completed, you will get this message. Now it's time to check the Docker version, what we have installed, Docker information, list the image. Image first we'll check the Docker information. What are things? Docker space info is the command. Hit enter. Once you hit enter, it will give all the details regarding the Docker that you have installed. For example, number of containers, images, how many images are there, server version, what is the server version, storage driver, login drivers, then operating system on what is the base operating system on which we are installed, OS type, is it Windows, Unix, what is the server configuration. It's even giving the memory, what is the memory, host name of the system, root directory for the Docker where we have installed. Now it's time to check the Docker version. The command is docker space version. Once you hit enter, it will give you the Docker version information. The version is this API version, Go version, build, all the details. Now we will see how many Docker images we have installed. Command is Docker space images. This is the command docker space images to check the list of docker images that we have installed on this system. Hit enter. As you can see, repository name, then tag is nano server, image ID, created, when it was created, what is the size. That's it, guys. Thanks for watching this video. You will get more videos on Docker, containers, and Azure in future. Kindly subscribe my channel. Have a nice day. Bye bye.